Coming to laryngocele, laryngocele is any chronic increase in transglottic pressure as in seen in the trumpet player, glass blower. So they blow the instruments and there is an increase in the transglottic pressure, a chronic increase, because they are chronic, they play several times. So there is a chronic increase in the transglottic pressure, also seen in the carcinoma of the ventricle of the vocal cord, larynx. So this allows the air to enter into the saccule. So the air get entered, but exit of the air is prevented. So there is an enlargement of the saccule. So this leads to lateral extension of the mucus of the ventricle and leading to laryngocele, which is intrinsic in nature. But when this laryngocele pierces the thyroid membrane, the pressure on the anterior neck, it becomes extrinsic. We can see by increase the size by Valsalva maneuver. So when we do the Valsalva maneuver, the swelling of extrinsic swelling we can see. So there is a Bryce sign. What is the Bryce sign? If we compress that external swelling, there is a exit of that air and leading to a sharp sound, hushing sound. So this is known as Bryce sign. So clinical feature is hoarseness and cough. So what is the surgery or the management? Excision by open neck surgery, and second is marsupialization. Now coming to laryngeal wave. Laryngeal wave is an incomplete recanalization of the laryngotracheal groove during the development. Most common site is at the level of glottis. So it is at the level of glottis, so there will be a child present with weak cry. So cry is abnormal. 90% anteriorly located. Severe case, it present with stridor. So what is the management? Division of the wave by CO2 laser or ciliastic keel is secured between the vocal cord and the anterior commissure. So division of the wave by the CO2 laser and ciliastic keel is secured between the vocal cord and the anterior commissure. So this is all about the some laryngeal diseases.